Okay, quickly, I want to show y'all a project technique that I taught quite a few years ago, probably late 90s, maybe early, even into the early 2000s, when I was doing a lot of rubber stamping and a lot of demos. And this was my spin on another technique that just had a lot more product involved. This was a little easier. I used to have a die cut business, and I die cut all these boxes. And we did them in cardstock and watercolor papers and all kind of different surfaces. And I started doing some out of Mylar, clear acetate. And we stamped on the outside of the box using a permanent or archival ink. If you use archival, you just had to let it set up a little longer. If you used a permanent ink, like stays on, it dried almost instantly and you could go right into your next steps. Then what we would do is flip the piece over, and this one uses metallic paint. I've got three or four different colors here that I just probably used my fingers. It's been so long ago, I don't really remember what I used. But the idea was just coating the backside or the inside of the box with the metallic paint. And then if the paint was still wet, you could quickly press the tissue paper onto it. If not, you could let the metallic paint set up a few minutes and then use Royal Coat decoupage medium, brush over it, press the tissue paper into it, and once that was dry, then you could peel or carefully tear or use scissors and trim the tissue paper off. And there you had a really super unique die cut box. This one has been taken apart and put back together so many times as a demo piece. I don't know if I can get it to go back like it was or not. This was called a pillow box and was just real popular, especially during the holidays. And then that would be the shape of the box. And you could seal these down completely, or we used to just use ribbon or that stretchy elastic stuff. But that was just a really quick project, so I thought I would show y'all because I found this while rummaging through stuff, and it just brought back a lot of memories.